lucky guess.
Ah, and then you're fine.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
I'll get another.
Hello everyone. We are going to start in another 5 minutes. There's a final 5 minutes. So, final 5 minutes. I just wanted to welcome everybody here today, tonight to our MLP Kila. But first, Kila, please get the Sula, their name, Pui Maua Luna, Maua Letua. Yeah, the Wapa Lele, what it? Suma Murphy Taele. Yeah, no Amale. Murphy, I see you here. And on this table here, can I please get Fred Mees, Jay Mees, and also your power numbers, please. And on this table here, can I please get Niall, Stacey, and also Lucky McLean, to see the waiting. And on this table here, can I please get Alice? For Paul Mills, Kelly for Paul Mills, and also David from Marshall David from Hospital Orders. You see the way to go here. And on this table here, can I bring the ice, meeting from Tom and Gills, En mijn vrienden voor mijn hand op alle sprint.
Okay, young people, let's hear a word of
This is especially for you, young people. Rejoice, O young man, in your youth, and let your heart cheer you in the days of your youth. Walk in the ways of your heart and in the sight of your eyes, but know that for all things God will bring you into judgment. Remember now your Creator in the days of your youth, before the critical days come, and the years draw near when you say, I have no pleasure in them. Rejoice your youth, follow your heart, and follow your vision. The Bible says, the sight of your eyes, that means your vision. Don't follow your eyes, follow your vision. Because your eyes, that is when you look at the temptation. Don't follow what you see, follow what you saw. What you saw is the vision that God gave you. Don't follow that. We are in the bad days. These days, they call it the perilous days. And the Bible said, all this that you do, don't forget, there will be a judgment day that will judge whatever you do in this world, whether it's good or bad. So therefore, do good. Praise the Lord. Follow your dreams, young people. Pursue your career. Mom and Dad, don't kill your child's dream. Leave them alone, give them as much space as they need. We come here tonight, especially to support them. So, give them some space. Thank you, Father, for bringing us together here tonight. We thank you so much, Lord, that you are out there, you are the unseen King, that you can look over us, and know all of us, Father, by names. And we thank you that you can protect us and direct us, especially our young people, Lord. Give them their dreams, Lord. Let them shine for you, Lord. Give them careers for their life. And Father, we ask you to equip them with your love, Lord, and direct their path to you, Lord. Make them a successful child for you, Lord. I ask you for your blessing upon all the parents and all the supporters tonight. Bless all of us here in this building, Father. In the name of our Lord Jesus, our Lord and our Savior. And everybody say, Amen and Amen. Praise the Lord. Othello. So I'm going to introduce our MC for tonight. And I'm going to say something or give an insight of what they thought about the Ivan program this year. That is Wu-Tang and also this.
I love the opportunity to come here. You know, not just with another
food, but also learn a lot about being and mental health and mental health, the fitness of the business. I think they're in Rachel, Casey, Mark, and everyone else is going to be there. Which is from NAB College, so give a big round of
applause. time to talk about, so it's really an honor for us to be here tonight to actually share this time and celebrate this amazing place. You know, hearing the two girls talk about their experiences here in the Aiga as fathers, it makes my heart feel warm. I also have two young daughters, and so I hope one day they're able to experience an amazing career. Yeah, so I guess they haven't really kind of been told what to speak about, so of course just kind of probably just talk a little bit about upbringing, things that we've experienced that are probably just been my experience here around. And yeah, so my name is Mara Williams, I'm up to see, so my dad's Samoan, he's from California, and my mom is as much as the principal is out there, so I'll just try to make it appropriate for you to leave. So
can have those moments when you're playing touch in the backyard and they're smashing you, they're having fun and they're looking at your younger sister, and I appreciate those moments of making the person that I am today. So playing rugby, transitioning into rugby from touch at was quite cool for me to do something and know that it was an opportunity for females to play sport and to actually be paid for it. I was kind of lucky enough to come into the team when they reformed contracts, so I walked out of school into a $50,000 contract that you know for a female, a Māori, a young Porikia from Rotiki to come out of school and to be able to be given the opportunity to travel the world. Travel business class, pretty special. We need to go see some cool sites, with many countries, and you know, you get to experience these moments that us young kids who, I'm a little bit similar to Noel in terms of my upbringing. We didn't have much, but we had a lot of support from my whānau. We had food on the table, we didn't have all the latest brands, you know, we didn't have phones and all that sort of stuff, but I love my upbringing and I'm real grateful for the lessons it taught me. As long as my whānau is supporting, you know, the resilience that we have to show to be professional sports people these days. So, like you said, we go every day, go to training in the morning, in the afternoon, go home, recover, rest, eat, and then it's a repeat again, day in, day out. So it might seem easy to some, it might seem hard to some, but it's an enjoyment factor, and I feel like the one thing that as young kids growing up is that you should do is do things because you love it, you know, go out and play with your friends, or you guys are doing today, training hard, working hard, to do what you want to do in the future, but there's always challenges along the way, and me and Noel have probably been on similar journeys, massive injuries along the way. I think I've had about 5 surgeries now, my knee, my shoulder, my wrist. So I'm only still 26, I'm still going to hang in there, not like my mate over here, she's a little bit older than me, but still carving me out, she's still filling in me, so I'm trying to keep on her toes. But yeah, there's a lot of challenges we've experienced in this professional day and age, and injuries are a massive part of it, but the support that we get in our system, from our sisters, from our management, from the union, it's actually massive, and I feel like it's a massive part of our culture. You know, having your family, your aina there to back you up, you know, there's got to be setbacks, there's got to be challenges along the way, but that's just a part of it, and the ones who actually succeed are the ones who can, you know, strive through all of the challenges and the obstacles that come along the way. So I suppose a piece of advice from me is to just never give up. Noel is probably one of the hardest, mentally strong people I've ever known, I'm going to be honest. And it's people like that I meet along the way, that you'll meet along the way, that will inspire you, that will help you grow and be better, not just athletes, but better people. And a big part of me in my life that I kind of, a life motto that I live by, so I've got all these quotes that I kind of have tucked away in my pocket. But I always think that nothing worth having will ever come easy, so life's not going to be given to you on a plate. You have to work hard. You know, you really, really got to find your passion and actually enjoy what you do. You shouldn't do it just to do it because, you made lots of money doing that, or, I'm going to do that because my friend's doing that. You know, it's got to be something you're real passionate about, and that's one thing I'm grateful about. Being a full-time backman, sevens player, there's so many positives to it. Like I said, a lot of challenges, but man, I'm just so grateful for the life that I get to live today. So for as long as my body can keep up, just like Nizzo here, I'll continue doing that. So yeah, just that's a little bit of my story of where I've come from, where I am now, and understanding that, you know, it's not always going to be easy, but it's always worth it in the end. So kia ora, kia ora, kia ora.
Does anyone have questions or, you know, anything they want to ask Niall and Stacey?
Combinations of that, but they literally, yeah, like you're fighting your mates for make the table just kind of weird and weird because the fish is not well, you know, the field, you're like, no, that's my spot. So we actually crossed over, it's for the World Cup that we're shooting to on the team who makes it, it's named tomorrow, but they didn't meet today, it's in South Africa, in Cape Town, so, yeah.
My horse of the committee, I have a big round of applause. So, next up, performance we have Tottenham Girls. Tottenham Girls have three performances. You girls want to get up and get ready.
Thank you.
for being here. Okay, this is number 1. We are going to give a 10-minute break, just so that the student can get all the other brew ready, and we'll commence on them. 10-minute break, and we'll get back into it.
And I'm a
just want to say thank you to my mum, my sister, and my sister's partner, and also my father for preparing for us tonight. I hope you guys all enjoyed it. Not long now, I just want to bring on in front here Rachel, Case, and also Mark. You guys can come up here, please. So we are the facilitators for Bahaina Program, where your kids come every Tuesdays and Thursdays, learning about their culture, getting a workout, but most importantly having fun, but also coming together in the community. When we first started this program, we wanted to make sure that it's a community-based program, and looking out here tonight, I think we have achieved that. But yeah, I just wanted to give these guys a bit of a prop, because there is no IMT, and if it wasn't for these guys here, the IMT program wouldn't have existed. So if you could all give us a bit of a round of applause. And last of all, I just want to say thank you to the teachers. Thank you for believing in our vision that we have here for the IEM program, for our kids, for speaker kids, and allowing them to get the parents to say yes, it's okay to come into our IEM program. Thank you very much for your support. It means a lot to us, and if it wasn't for you guys too, you wouldn't have seen this performance tonight, and tonight would have never happened. So can we give a round of applause to all our teachers? And lastly, I just want to hate me for this, but could our chairman, Craig Mees, are you able to come up and say a little something? So Bahaina is one of the few programs that we have under the Bay of Plenty Youth Development Trust. And Craig, he's our chairman, but also he had the vision for all our Māori and all our kids to come in here into a space. Like we always say, welcome to our gym, welcome to our buddy, or most importantly what we like to call it, welcome to the House of Hope. And this is Craig Mees, our chair.
Well, thank you, Henry. You can interpret my thank you many ways. I wasn't expecting this, but truly I sat here tonight just thinking how lucky we are to be able to put something together like this. Great team that Henry's introduced you to. As a board and as a person here to help and trust, and our directors, and we're so proud of our team. And they put on one of the programs we run, as you can see tonight, this is the first major program that we've first major sort of festivity, that we've had in our new premise, and I think you'll all agree it worked very well. As it said, the food was excellent. I do believe that someone told me that the table food was a step up from the other food, and I feel quite guilty about that because I had far more than I should have. And but that's Henry's parents' fault for having such good quality food. Teachers, that you bring these kids along, we appreciate that, and we wouldn't have a program if we didn't do that. The kids, the young people, I hope, and I know that I can just tell by the way that you are, and the way you're reacting, and the progress you've made, that you benefit from being in our program, and it's your program, and your family, and this is how this whole thing works. And you know, we want you as whānau, family members, we want you to be part of what we do here. There's no close-off date for your participation in the program we run. And we just enjoy the journey with you, and we thank you again for being here tonight and making this such a successful occasion. Thank you.
And lastly, our last performance for tonight, I would like to invite Lyle and Stacey. If you guys are able to finish off with a few star more, someone call it. Yeah, man, we love that all. So you